Welcome back to my YouTube channel Nastrin Padasalai. In today's video, we are going to see the exam pattern for this Indian Forest Service examination. We are going to see what is the exam pattern, for how many marks you need to write, and what is the time duration of the exam, and what are the negative markings available for the exam, and what are the three stages of this particular exam. So with no particular delay, let's get started. So for IFS examination, you need to clear three stages. First stage is the prelims or a preliminary examination. Next stage is the mains, and it is a written examination. After clearing this mains, then you will be called for an interview, which is nothing but your personality test. So there are three stages of this IFS examination. With regard to prelims, it is just same as that of your civil service examination. Okay, so if any of your friends or your seniors are preparing for IAS and IPS, you can get the preparation from them. Even question paper will be same for this preliminary examination. Only difference is that for IFS, the cutoff of prelims will be greater than for if IPS and IAS. If the cutoff is 100, means for IFS it is 120, just like that, friends. So we'll see detailedly what is this prelims and all. So for the prelims, which is also called as preliminary examination, it is just like your objective type of question, and there will be two paper, paper 1 and paper 2. Paper 1 is for general studies and paper 2 is for the CS aptitude test, that is your common civil service exam aptitude test. So you need to appear for this paper 1. After that, you also need to appear for this paper 2, and totally 200 questions will be asked from this general studies paper, and each question will carry 1 mark. So total marks is 200 marks. For paper 2, it is civil service aptitude test, and totally 80 questions will be asked, and each question will carry 2.5 marks, and totally your marks is 200. Okay, and there is also a negative marking, like 1/3 of your mark will be reduced if you give a wrong answer. So to qualify the prelims, you need to have 33% so that you will qualify your preliminary examination. Okay, so next. So the next thing is your mains examination. So if you qualified your preliminary stage of your examination, then you will be called for this IFS mains examination. Okay, so this main will have a written test and an interview. Total marks for this mains is 1700 marks. In that, 1400 marks will be taken for your written examination, and 300 will be taken for your personality test, which is nothing but after you clear this written examination, you will be called for an interview test. The main aim of this personality test is that whether you are eligible to serve for the community, or whether you can able to solve any situation, you can able to take any judgmental proof. They will analyze and evaluate you in various aspects. They will check your alertness of your minds. So this is the last stage of IFS examination. Now we'll see about this written examination, friends. So IFS written examination is having totally 6 papers are there. Okay, so paper number 1 is general English. Okay, so all the 6 papers are written type. This means you need to write paragraph, okay, so that you should have a key on your handwriting, whether you can able to write them correctly or not, just like that. So first paper is general English, and it will carry 300 marks. Paper number 2 is your GK, where they will give you GK answer type or some questions related to that, and you need to write them paragraphly, and for 300 marks the paper will be there. Next paper, like paper 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so you need to select any 2 subject from the optional given in the syllabus. So if you take your syllabus, you will have optionals. If you not, I had uploaded a video related. I will upload a video related to what are the optional subjects available in this IFS examination. Okay, so there is a list of 10 optional subjects, and in the 10 you need to select any 2 subject. Okay, so each subject will have two paper. So let me explain you with an example, friends. So consider this. For example, if you are selecting forest, if I am selecting zoology and forestry as my optional subject, means in zoology I will have zoology paper number 2, zoology paper number 1 and zoology paper number 2. This zoology paper number 1 will have 200, we will write for 200 marks, and zoology paper number 2 we will write for 200 marks. Next, forestry. Okay, I already said you have to select two optional. So first I selected zoology as my optional. Next is this forestry. Forestry also, forestry paper number 1 and it is for 2 marks. And forestry paper number 2, it is also for 2 marks. So the total marks is 1400. Okay, so this is how you need to write for this IFS examination. So that's it for today's video, friends. If you like my video, please click the like button. If you didn't subscribe to my YouTube channel, then please click the subscribe button below. Thank you, friends. Thanks for watching.